All India Radio presents Morning News. Good morning, I'm Anuja Kumar. The headlines. Prime Minister Narendra Modi says Gaganyaan Mission will be a historic achievement for India in 21st century. Ganga Yatra under Namami Gange Mission to begin from Bijnor and Ballia in Uttar Pradesh today. Death toll due to novel coronavirus rises to 80 in China. No Indian affected by the outbreak, says External Affairs Ministry. Rohan Bopanna and his Ukrainian partner Nadiia Kichenok enter mixed doubles quarterfinals of Australian Open tennis in Melbourne. And India's Saurav Ghosal storms into final of Pittsburgh Open Squash tournament. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has said that the Gaganyaan mission will be a historic achievement for India in 21st century. In his Mann Ki Baat program on All India Radio last evening, Mr. Modi said it will prove to be a milestone for New India.
2022 में हमारी आजादी के 75 साल पूरे होने वाले हैं और उस मौके पर हमें गगनयान मिशन के साथ एक भारतवासी को अंतरिक्ष में ले जाने के अपने संकल्प को सिद्ध करना है। गगनयान मिशन 21वीं सदी में साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी के क्षेत्र में भारत की एक ऐतिहासिक उपलब्धि होगा। नए भारत के लिए यह एक मील का पत्थर साबित होगा।
Mr. Modi praised the four pilots of the Indian Air Force who have been selected as astronauts for the mission and their forthcoming training in Russia. The Prime Minister said these promising youngsters symbolize India's skill, talent, ability, courage and dreams. Mr. Modi said violence cannot be a solution to any issue and any problem can be resolved by seeking solutions and not by creating another one. The Prime Minister appealed to the people to return to the mainstream, especially those who are still seeking solutions to problems through violence and weapons. Mr. Modi said, few days ago in Assam, 644 militants from 8 militant groups surrendered with their weapons and expressed faith in peace and decided to become a partner in the progress of the nation. He added that in Tripura, more than 80 people left the path of violence last year. He said solidarity is the key to resolve every issue and brotherhood will foil any attempts by the separatists to divide the people.
देशवासियों को यह जानकर बहुत प्रसन्नता होगी कि नॉर्थ ईस्ट में इंसर्जेंसी बहुत एक मात्रा में कम हुई है और इसकी सबसे बड़ी वजह यह है इस क्षेत्र से जुड़े हर एक मुद्दे को शांति के साथ ईमानदारी से चर्चा करके सुलझाया जा रहा है. देश के किसी भी कोने में अब भी हिंसा और हथियार के बल पर समस्याओं का समाधान खोज रहे लोगों से अपील करता हूं वे वापस लौट आए मुद्दों को शांतिपूर्ण तरीके से सुलझाने में अपनी और इस देश की क्षमताओं पर भरोसा रखें.
The Prime Minister said the new decade of 2020 has brought a new ray of hope in the life of the Brew Riang community. He was referring to the agreement which has ended the 25-year-old problem of Brew Riang refugee crisis. Mr. Modi said the agreement is special as it symbolizes the spirit of cooperative federalism and it epitomizes the inherent compassion and sensitivity of Indian culture. The Prime Minister congratulated the Assam government and the people of the state for successfully hosting the third Khelo India Games. Mr. Modi said in just 3 years, through Khelo India Games, 3,200 gifted children have emerged on the sporting horizon.
राष्ट्रीय खेल प्रतियोगिता के माध्यम से जहां खिलाड़ियों को अपना पैशन दिखाने का मौका मिलता है वहीं वे दूसरे राज्यों की संस्कृति से भी रूबरू होते हैं इसलिए हमने खेलो इंडिया यूथ गेम्स की तर्ज पर ही हर वर्ष खेलो इंडिया यूनिवर्सिटी गेम्स भी आयोजित करने का निर्णय लिया है साथियों अगले महीने 22 फरवरी से 1 मार्च तक ओडिशा के कटक और भुवनेश्वर में पहले खेलो इंडिया यूनिवर्सिटी गेम्स आयोजित हो रहे हैं.
The Prime Minister expressed confidence that after interaction with students in Pariksha Pe Charcha, the youth is brimming with self-confidence and is ready to take on the challenges. He said, Fit India School campaign, which began in November last year, is yielding results and more than 65,000 schools have obtained the Fit India School certificates. He also appealed the countrymen to promote more physical activity in their daily routine. The Prime Minister appreciated the participation of people in water conservation, saying, extensive and innovative efforts are underway in every corner of the country to save water. He said Jal Shakti campaign, which commenced last monsoon, is taking rapid and successful strides with public participation. The Prime Minister said, like every year, last evening Padma Awards were announced and he urged people to read about each of the awardees. He said Padma Awards have now become the people's awards. The Prime Minister said the extraordinary stories of their lives will inspire the society in the true spirit. Mr. Modi mentioned about Shailesh from Bihar, who shared a Mann Ki Baat charter that offered glimpses of the issues covered in the monthly radio program over various episodes. He said the Mann Ki Baat charter is very innovative and people can join any cause of their choice listed in the Mann Ki Baat charter. Wishing the countrymen on Republic Day celebrations, the Prime Minister hoped that the new decade will bring new resolve and new achievements for each citizen and for the country. Bharat Parv 2020, a festival to celebrate the spirit of India, has begun at Red Fort Ground in New Delhi. It will continue till the 31st of January. The objective of Bharat Parv is to encourage people to visit different tourist places of the country and to inculcate the spirit of Dekho Apna Desh. More from our correspondent.
Bharat Parv have many attractions for public, including the display of tableaus of the Republic Day Parade, performance by armed forces bands and cultural performances from different regions of the country. More than 50 food stalls, 79 handicraft stalls and 27 theme pavilions have been set up. The theme of this year's Bharat Parv is Ek Bharat, Shreshth Bharat and celebrating 150 years of Mahatma Gandhi. The festival will remain open for public from 12 noon to 10 p.m. till 31st of this month. The entry to the event for the public is free. With Deependra Kumar, Tanvi Khurana, AIR News, Delhi.
Human Resource Development Minister Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank has said that government is committed to provide quality, innovative education to all the students, which paves the way for multifaceted development. Mr. Pokhriyal said this while felicitating 87 meritorious students from across the country in New Delhi yesterday. He said that the students are the future of the country and the responsibility of creating a new and prosperous India is on them. The minister added that India has the largest number of youth population and this strength can make the country a global superpower and an economic giant. These students also witnessed the Republic Day parade yesterday. This is All India Radio giving you the news. For quick news updates round the clock, follow us on our Twitter handle at AIR News Alerts. The 5-day Ganga Yatra under Namami Gange Mission will kick off today from Bijnor and Ballia in Uttar Pradesh. UP Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath, Uttarakhand CM Trivendra Singh Rawat and Union Minister Sanjeev Balyan will launch the Yatra from Bijnor, a place where Ganga enters Uttar Pradesh. Governor Anandibhen Patel, Union Minister Mahendranath Pandey and Deputy Chief Minister of Bihar, Sushil Modi, will launch it from Ballia in eastern UP, where the Holy River leaves the state to enter Bihar. Rajiv Ranjan Mishra, DG, National Mission for Clean Ganga, told AIR that the aim of the Yatra is to promote biodiversity. More from our correspondent.
The two yatras will cover more than 1,350 kilometers route in 27 districts before culminating in Kanpur on January 31st. Many programs are scheduled at the intermediate points of the yatra at Meerut, Amroha, Ghazipur, Mirzapur, Varanasi and Prayagraj districts. Jan Sabhas and Ganga Aartis will be organized at most stops. The state government has already passed directions for setting up Ganga Maidans in all Gram Sabhas, starting of Ganga Melas, establishment of Ganga Khel Park and many other Ganga theme-based development projects along the river. Sushil Chandra Tiwari, AIR News, Lucknow.
In Rajasthan, one suspected case of coronavirus has been reported in Jaipur. The patient has been shifted in isolation ward of Savai Man Singh Medical College. State Health Minister Raghu Sharma said that the suspect has returned from China after completing his MBBS degree. India has stepped up vigil in districts bordering Nepal in response to the confirmed case of novel coronavirus in the Himalayan nation. It is informed that more than 4,000 passengers were screened yesterday and no case was found. Death toll in novel coronavirus in China has risen to 80. National Health Commission said 2,750 people have tested positive for the deadly virus globally, with 33 cases overseas. In addition to this, 5,794 suspected cases have also come up in China, mostly in Wuhan City. A total of 30 provincial-level jurisdictions in China and Hong Kong have activated their highest-level emergency response amid the coronavirus outbreak. Meanwhile, the External Affairs Ministry has said that as of now, no Indian in China has been affected by the coronavirus outbreak. In a series of tweets, External Affairs Ministry spokesman Ravish Kumar said Indian Embassy in Beijing is in close touch with Indian citizens, including students, to extend assistance. He said External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar is closely monitoring the situation. Meanwhile, Canada confirmed its first case of the deadly coronavirus from China. Officials said a patient who recently flew from Wuhan is being treated at a hospital in Toronto. The News Services Division of All India Radio, in its weekly bilingual live phone-in program, Public Speak, will bring you a discussion tonight on Voter Awareness, Key to Strong Democracy. This can be heard on FM Gold Channel and additional frequencies from 9:30 p.m. Listeners can ask questions to the experts sitting in our studio on toll-free telephone number 1-800-115-7767. You can also ask questions on telephone number 011-231-4444 and post queries on our Twitter handle at AIR News Alerts by hashtag AskAIR. You can also follow us on the News on AIR app for updates. This program is also available on Doordarshan DTH. Rohan Bopanna and his Ukrainian partner Nadiia Kichenok have progressed to the mixed doubles quarterfinals of Australian Open tennis in Melbourne. They defeated the team of Nicole Melisha and Bruno Suarez in their second round yesterday. Leander Paes and Jelena Ostapenko reached the mixed doubles second round. They will next face American Bethany Mattek-Sands and Briton Jamie Murray. Paes is competing in his last Australian Open, having announced that 2020 is his final year on the pro circuit. In men's singles, Roger Federer and Novak Djokovic swept into the quarterfinals. India's Saurav Ghosal made his way into the final of Pittsburgh Open Squash Tournament. He defeated the fifth seed Egypt's Omar Musab in a thrilling contest in Pittsburgh, United States. Ghosal will now take on top seed Egyptian Faris Dissouki in the summit clash. And now for an overview of today's newspapers, it's over to Paul Thottam.
Thank you, Anuja. Highlighting the cultural diversity, the Daily's report on the several firsts marking the 71st Republic Day. The Asian Age reports all-women CRPF team makes stellar debut, while the Hindustan Times writes anti-drone system used for the first time this Republic Day parade. The Pioneer says, in a first, the PM pays tribute to martyrs at National War Memorial. A Hindu headline writes, Chinook, heavy lift, and Apache helicopters make their debut during the Republic Day flypast. Ahead of the budget, the Economic Times reports, boost likely in rural pensions, the paper adds, payouts for senior citizens, widows, divyang may rise. Another headline in the Indian Express reports, green shoots, mid caps, small caps, a rally in New Year, bring hope of revival in economy. And finally, after pioneering heart transplants in India, AIIMS offers city's first lung transplants, reports the Times of India. And with that, it's back to you, Anisha.
Thank you, Paul. And now, before we end the bulletin, the headlines once again. Prime Minister Narendra Modi says Gaganyaan Mission will be a historic achievement for India in 21st century. Ganga Yatra under Namami Gange Mission to begin from Bijnor and Ballia in Uttar Pradesh today. Death toll due to novel coronavirus rises to 80 in China. No Indian affected by the outbreak, says External Affairs Ministry. Rohan Bopanna and his Ukrainian partner Nadiia Kichenok enter mixed doubles quarterfinals of Australian Open tennis in Melbourne. And India's Saurav Ghosal storms into final of Pittsburgh Open Squash Tournament. And with that, we end the morning news. Have a nice day.